Ladies and gentlemen, dear authorities and friends, good morning and welcome to the 12th IAG Congress. It is an honor and a pleasure to chair this Congress, which is of particular importance for our association. Indeed, this year we celebrate the 50th anniversary of the IAEG Foundation, occurred in 1964 in New Delhi. This year, the Congress is hosted by Torino, which was the first capital city of Italy after its reunification. Torino, for its history, development and economical activities, encloses and represents different traditions and cultures, first of the entire Italy, and more recently also of many other parts of the world. Now we are here at the Lingotto, which was the first Fiat car factory, and now has become one important conference center designed by the famous architect Renzo Piano. This represents a good example of the modern evolution on this city. Engineering geology plays a major role in the definition of human responses to the changes of a dynamic environment. The role of territorial planning for a sustainable use of available geo and water resources and a proper management of natural hazard is ever more needed. In this context, the IAEG during the last 50 years has tried to interpret the needs of society and the territory, and also in this occasion wants to provide solution to these issues. For this reason, we have thought that the most appropriate title for the Congress is Engineering Geology for Society and Territory. This proposal was appreciated in Auckland during the last Congress in 2010, which assigned to Torino the prestigious task of hosting and organizing the 12th Congress. I was conscious of the great work that expected us and the numerous difficulties we were going to face. However, we could not imagine the progressive hardship of the international economic situation, and in particular of the Italian one. This could have limited the number of potential participants to the Congress, and thus the success of this event. In order to overcome these difficulties, we invited a large number of scientists, academics and professionals of many parts of the world to submit their contribution. Initially, we obtained 1,800 abstract submissions, which have been confirmed in 1,450 full papers. Due to the strict scheduling necessary to achieve publication of the proceeding before the Congress, we solicited repeatedly the authors and the conveners to respect guidelines and deadlines for the submission and review of the papers. This ambition stimulated numerous conveners who committed themselves to collect a large number of contributions from all parts of the world and to select the best papers through to review stage. This had this had as recompense the publication of 1,304 papers of good scientific quality and about 1,000 registration at the Congress. The results obtained are thus higher than what expected and rewarded our efforts. The Congress proceedings delivered on time are now published by Springer as a collection of 8 volumes for a total of 8,640 pages. This is now a reality, thanks to the active support of authors, conveners and reviewers, to the good service given by Springer, and mainly to the hard work and the efficient management of the Scientific Secretariat. We would like to remind you that all the participants will receive the CD containing all the volume set. The proceeding, also for the variety in the topics addressed, have the ambition to respond to different requests and needs of the international community for a more appropriate management of the territory and of its specific problems. The book series is edited by several prominent international scientists and testify the evolution of engineering geology during the last 50 years and aims at constituting a milestone for our association and a bridge for the development and the challenges of engineering geology towards the future. The 8 volumes, one for each topic, are organized in sessions and also contain the lectures of prominent scientists and well-known representatives of IAG who will share this great experience during their lectures. As the proceeding, the Congress is organized in 8 topics, and they will include, first, climate change and engineering geology. This is one of the hot topics in the scientific community and is also of large impact on the society. In these topics, more than 100 contributions will be presented within sessions that will focus on the effects of climate change on geomorphological processes, natural resources and energy security. Moreover, the role of geoscience and of engineering geology in a climate change scenario will be also discussed. The second topic, landslide processes. This topic has been the one totalizing the largest number of contributions. The contributions, which are about 400, have been collected in 2 tomes. Proportionally, we will host several important keynote lectures on these themes. The scientific session will touch different aspects relevant to the landslide processes, prevention, protection, forecast, risk mitigation, monitoring and modeling. Most of them are chaired by famous scientists. The topic 3, river basin, reservoir sedimentation and water resources. In this topic, more than 100 presentations will be delivered during the Congress. The focus of this topic is water and its Pacific management. Water is recognized as the most important resource for the human and animal life, for the agricultural activities and for energy production. The engineer geology activities are aimed at achieving an appropriate management of this resource, but also at providing method and tools to mitigate the risk associated to extreme events as floods and droughts. Marine and coastal processes. The presentation of this theme will regard mainly coastal and offshore geodisasters, many of them analyzing the effect tsunami events, as well as the cause and effect of subsidence processing occurring in the traditional, in transitional coastal environments. Urban geology, sustainable planning and landscape exploitation. This topic will be the second largest one discussed at the Congress, totalizing about 300 contributions. The presentation will focus on different geohazards and their impact on urban environment, in situ and remote sensing techniques, aquifer and their pollution, construction materials. Also in this field, we have several lectures delivered by prominent international scientists. The six topics, applied geology for major engineering project. Applied geology, soil and rocks mechanics, major engineering project, their design and their effect on the surrounding environment are probably the scientific discipline dealt with historically by our association. About 200 presentations will be delivered on this theme. Prominent representative of IAEG will go through all these aspects by sharing their large work experience all over the world. Topic 7, education, professional ethics and public recognition of engineering geology. Despite this theme has always been treated as discussed as a borderline issue, in the Congress we have decided to give to this topic more importance by hosting several sessions. This has been appreciated as demonstrated by the relatively large number of contributions received. I think that this has to be considered also in the future, and I hope that this scientific session will trigger fruitful discussions. The last topic is preservation of cultural heritage. Last but not least, to the presentation of cultural heritage, we have dedicated a specific topic, which particularly in Italy, but also at the international level, is assuming more and more importance. Indeed, we received also the patronage of UNESCO for this initiative. Also, in this case, we received a good feedback from the participants, and more than 100 presentations will cover several aspects from the study of the construction materials to geological and geotechnical influences in the preservation of the cultural heritage. The scientific program has been organized in oral and poster presentation by following the preference of the authors and the selection made by the session's conveners. In addition to the traditional session, several workshops and short courses have been scheduled in the scientific program, including those related to IAEG Commission, in order to give them the possibility to have a public discussion on their activities, achievement and future programs, increasing their visibility. Moreover, social events for the participant and the accompanying person will add a flavor of the Italian tradition and cultures. I would like to point out that the keynote lectures and also the contribution of other prominent scientists will be video recorded during the Congress. In this way, this important contribution can be shared all over the world and transferred to a large number of people, reaching also remote areas. This, joined with the Springer book series, will allow this Congress to live also after the end of the Congress. Last but not least, I would like to focus the attention on the possibility that the IAEG bylaw offer to developing and low-income countries. This year, our President Carlos Delgado has increased the budget available to support the fee registration to the IAEG Congress. This has allowed to the organizing committee to accept all the 60 requests received. In addition, I would also like to announce a new initiative for low-income countries. It is my intention to award a scholarship of 1 year to a young graduate from a developing or low-income countries. Since I chair the IAEG Commission C35 on monitoring methods and approach in engineering geology application, and I am also leading a research group working at CNR IRPI in Turin on this topic. The scholarship will be focused on these topics and hosted by this group. I hope that this will contribute to promote a stronger and more active presence of IAEG in the world, and especially in the remote areas. In this context, I also hope that this can be the start of new activities promoted by IAEG. This activity can be supported by exploiting the experience of our prominent academics and professionals, young and retired, and also by involving public institutions and leading companies operating in engineer geology fields sensitive to this theme. The first who collect my invitation in this direction was the director of my research institute, and later he will illustrate this joint proposal. I wish you that this Congress and the initiative promoted can stimulate, support, and inspire your research on the professional activity, and that in this crazy time of hostility, this event could testify a more constructive and peaceful interaction among the international community. Finally, I would like to thank all the authors, the convener, the keynote speaker, and all the colleagues of the organizing committee that with their efforts have made this event possible. I take this occasion to wish all the best to the organizer of the next IEAG Congress in 2018. I wish you all a great 12th IEAG Congress. Thank you.